All right, this is Jerry. We're going to do another bond update. Hey, today we're going to talk about South Penn. There really haven't been a lot of changes over there. They're waiting for shrouds for the shelter. The shrouds keep debris from penetrating into the building in case of a tornado and the air conditioners get took off. So over there, the EFIS is done. We're not forgetting them. We're just going to hit them the next time we go down. Right now, we're going to go down and take a look at the student services and the B entry, and then we'll end up down at South Penn before it's over. Hey, we're in the B entry now. You can see around. Everybody started doing the ceilings, the paint's starting to come together. We're having lots of different things going on. Juan and his crew, the gentleman right here, they're responsible for all this high ceiling work you see with the wood islands and the clouds and everything. It's pretty cool stuff. Let's walk on in here where the CSRs are. Classrooms and stuff. You got the main desk here with the rock, and then you'll see behind there the CSRs are set. And then you start our offices. And in here, this area right here is where Robin's going to be. She's down here in the corner where Carla Marshall was at one time. It was my office at one time. Now it's not. She's going to have great windows. This is going to be a great little area right here. And there's some features that I hadn't mentioned in the past. The new fire you see up here, this is going to talk to us. When we're all said and done, when we have fire drills, you're going to have not only just the beeping and stuff going on, but when we have lockdowns and stuff, you're going to hear sound. You're going to hear a pre-recorded message come across telling everybody what the drill is. And it'll be in every area you see a strobe. So it's going to be tied into the fire. It's going to be pretty cool. They'll also have a button, emergency button you push. When you push that emergency button, all the doors are going to lock on the exterior. It's automatically going to call the police. It's going to let me and the deputies know. It's going to be a pretty cool system. We're really excited about it. And this is where you'll come into Ed Services. You're going to have a permanent person sitting here that'll address everybody, hook you up with the career counselors, the bursars back here. It's going to be pretty cool. Let's take a look around real quick. This is going to be Education Services break room. I love this room. It's awesome. It's going to have a lot of light. It's going to be some kind of curvy tables right here in the middle with some squares on the end. It's going to be a great room. This is the entry into the assessment area. And this is where you'll set up to take any tests. The waiting area lockers are in here. New desk and everything. It's going to be pretty cool. This is one of our typical testing rooms. It has the cameras that's required. All these desks and stuff will move to the end. They're still trying to put data cabling and power in right now, so it's not complete. We're gonna head out the back door here. Hey, I wanna show you guys the new server room. It is awesome. I wanna show you. First, we're gonna look at the old server room. I wanna show y'all what we had and what we've been working with. Okay, this is our server room. More or less a closet with a whole bunch of blinky lights and a lot of wire. Let's go look at what we're getting. You can see it's quite a substantially more room. We have two crack units here. These things are redundant. They can run on our chill water system during the daytime, and when we turn our chill water off at night, they become a DX or a standard air conditioner. You can see this is the back side of the rack. They haven't populated it with actually servers or anything yet, but they have the UPS and all that in. But this is going to be a really, really cool room. Let's head down to the D area and let's show y'all it. On our way down to D, we're going to go ahead and cut by here. I want to show everybody the new parking lot. This is where our staff parking. See to my right over here where we keep the fleet at now. When we do phase three, which will be automotive and this C area admin, all that will be gone. The buildings actually stick out all the way into that parking area. So we had to find a new place to put the fleet. And we've done that down here in the southeast corner of the property. I plan on putting a fob on the key so that when you come down to check out a car, you'll push the fob, the gate will open, you go in, you'll have a spot to park your personal car, and then you can take the school vehicle with you, and your car's secure. You don't have to open any gates manually, so if you come in at night, it'd be a nice place to put everything up.
Okay.
We're gonna start here in the D area. We're gonna come in. What you see right here in front of us with the green board on it, that's gonna be cosmetology. They're in the process of framing it. We're gonna try to slide in here and see what we can. It's a lot of brick masonry going on, so we'll have to be real careful not to impede anybody's work. This first shop right here, this very first one's a machine shop. As you come into machine shop, you can see they're doing a lot of embeds. They'll hold all the rafters and stuff that come up. Have bar joists that go across, actually. Classrooms, there's a water jet. It goes in here, CNC water jet. Let's walk next door to welding. I'll take a look inside one of the welding shops, but when you look at these booths that they'll be working in, you can easily put several students in and do a demonstration, or they can put pipe. They have some stuff that's going to go in where they'll do pipe welding. these guys, the new welding instructors, are really, really doing a lot of new and cool stuff with pop welding, with the pop union. They're going to have gas welders that'll be, if you look over here, these two holes that are blocked out, they're actually going to have gas welders that'll sit outside so they can act like they're actually out on the pop line. They can really demonstrate or simulate real work conditions. Pretty cool. Right here to the right, you see the concrete structure? That's our north shelter. It's got classrooms in it and restrooms, but it's going to hold a lot of students. I forget, 300 students, something like that. There's another one, if you'll look south in that corner. That's our south shelter, and it will hold the remainder of the students that are in this area. The stuff you see right directly in front of us will be pre-engineering, CAD, all those. You can't really tell it, they hadn't started framing it yet, but all those classrooms go here. This is the shelter I said that was furthest to the south, and it has the restrooms we're standing in here now. But when the shelter's closed, there'll be a door here that stops you from going in the restrooms, and there's a door here that stops you from coming into this conference room. So when you're in the conference room and you lock down, you'll be able to access the restrooms from it or from the hallway, either way. It's gonna be a pretty cool design. This is a substantial building. I mean, this thing's 10 inches thick of concrete. It's got another 6 inches on the roof. So that's about it for today. We've looked at all of our projects that we have here, and we'll hit South Penn next time. Hopefully we'll have the shrouds in place and we can see the finishes there. Until then, bye-bye.